hey, this album here is one of them ones. You can really take Benny's whole discography and separate them out between the projects that got Derringer and Alchemist on the production and projects that don't. Out of the ones that do this, Tanatol 3 and Tanatol 4, you can really take your pick out of which one you think is Benny's best project. But regardless, this project here was huge for Benny. Tanatol 3 was Benny the Butcher's arrival, where he took his already elite rapping and matched it with the perfect aesthetic production-wise. Then the TT3 was Benny's arrival. Plugs was showing that Benny was here to stay, right? It's the difference between your girl pulling up and her starting to take up closet and counter space. She here to stay, my boy. But yeah, this project really confirmed that Benny is one of the best active rappers. We finna break it down.
This marathon shit, so let's see who first to the finish. If it's less than 100 racks, it don't deserve your attention, cause burdens come with it. My second test was serving a sentence. My first was make a brick jump like it was hurdling fences.
Yo, those opening bars are so cold. He's talking on them. I like that. If it's less than 100 racks, it don't deserve your attention bar. You know, anything over 1,000, you probably got my attention, but that's neither here nor there. But then I like those next bars too. My second test was serving a sentence, because the way that it sets up the my first test was making a brick jump line. Because like the fact that he started a second one is foreshadowing the next line. Like, what did he do to get locked up there? I think that's just good writing. And then to top everything off, he has this sick 5-syllable rhyme, which is really uncommon. And for him to do it as effortlessly as he does it is impressive, dog.
I'm fresh out of luck, I'm here cause I deserve to be nigga.
Still
I sat back
and
bet, watched beginners winning my belts. Burnt my bridges, came back a good swimmer like Phelps. You
that's
know the
so
feeling,
hard.
Young black
that's
male,
so
what
hard.
Y'all dealing? Take your bins in a break, then toss it back in the blender. That was us, next to a big like I was puffed. The good die young, all the OGs 30 and up.
That's just a crazy line. I heard similar lines, but all the OGs 30 and up lines, just showing you how much dudes is dying early.
All the OGs 30 and up, and Alexander McQueen kicks just the dirty him up. Money tree branches break when they not sturdy enough.
That's a good line, the money tree line. And hey, the Alexander McQueen line, you know, I'm not paying for shoes that cost that much, but respect the people who buy shoes and actually wear them. I can get behind that.
Water in my jewels, put them on and baptize hoes. Walk in my shoes, we got shack size soles. We flat
switch
my
up
nose,
the rhyme scheme, and
niggas wearing half
flow.
Size clothes. What's the dilly? I'm only about 6 hours from Philly. That's an hour on a plane. I make it 3 in the Bentley.
Yo, I love when hip hop references other hip hop. That was a reference to the Firm song, specifically the AZ verse. The what's the dilly? I just touched grounds down to Philly, brought a pound with me. The Firm could have been special, dog. But I like how the undertone is, if you've heard the Firm song, you know that he was talking about he touched down in Philly with some weight. And Benny is talking about drug running right here. That's good writing.
See, before I knew an A&R, I was waiting hard back when Nicki Minaj was in a training bra. Play this game, you better play it hard. The judge give you life, and later that day, he gonna be playing golf. I'm from
crazy.
That era, we don't pay it if you
crazy.
Waited wrong. Back when your parents got your baby shoes plated bronze.
I just had a son, so if I post a picture with his little baby Jordans with bronze paint on it, y'all already know what I'm referring to.
When we was hooked in a hood, getting booked, like literature kept us shook. Like when the boogeyman come in to get you, we was crooks. Trying to cop more rides and great adventure. Any image we took, not a father was in the picture.
Any image we took, not a father's in the picture. Is a crazy line, but I like how he's using this took internal rhyme scheme towards the beginning of each line, and then he's using this slanted 4-syllable rhyme at the end. Black Thought just got technical rapping down to a T. This nigga is in a different caliber than pretty much any other rapper.
Facing the darkest outcome, sprinting to outrun the reaper, trying
Bandit
not to
dog.
Be the food in the mouth for the beast for whom the bell tolls. Crown
kings
in the night of ads to Melrose without the dapper damn body bags and jail clothes. That
come on, dog. This is not regular, dog. I was talking about how good that 5-syllable rhyme scheme was from Benny. This is a slanted 6-syllable. The rapping is just ridiculous. Plus the imagery and the way that he's painting this picture of growing up through the struggle.
Chicken change, knowing broke niggas not the lollygag when hell rose. We railroaded through the thick of things for gold chains. And chicken change, knowing throwing flames is growing pains. When in a game and a blow, ashes in the snow, it's no remains. Push the wheel as fast as it could go. We overcame the obstacles, but when you official, the block miss you. Even if the
Facts.
Old food choose not the rock with you,
Facts.
It was blue black.
I like that line too, because he was talking about the OGs not rocking with the younger dudes in the game, and he was talking about the street life in that bar. But you can take that and apply it to hip-hop, where there's this divide between young rappers and old rappers. But on this song, Black Thought, who's been in the game, dang, I'm getting old, 30 years versus Benny the Butcher, with this being his arrival, like I was saying earlier, not embodying that same divide, that is real common for hip hop. I like that.
Triumph and tragedy, his majesty muscle. Never atrophy, the devil is a casualty sucker. You never capture me, even
this
though you've been after me, motherfucker.
Crazy.
You gotta bring up Jean Paul, Gaudier, Tom Ford, and Cartier self made. A fly vintage from the Somalia of reserve. Someone from the black.
The imagery of all these revolutionaries and leaders, come on, dog.
From public housing to the Atlas Mountains, I've established the average to always bat a thousand.
He's been using this ass sound in the last, I think, two or three rhyme schemes, and it's really making his flow sound sick.
Probably almost on par with all the Escobar's coat. When I'm finished, I'ma keep a tennis shoe on your throat, just in case you mention in an interview you want smoke, nigga. 2 for 10.
That song is special, dog. I think that song in and of itself is a modern classic. That's one of the better songs of the last decade. I think everything about it is perfection. I think the beat is amazing. You got this grainy lo-fi soul sample with the violins and those vocals. Real simple beat. It has that classic feel that really embodies the content of both verses. And speaking of the verses, man, they were amazing. At this point in time, and really to this day, if you put Black Thought on a song, you can almost chalk it up as you getting out rapped. Benny stuff with him, dog. I think you can go back and forth on who had the better verse on this song. I think this is one of the best verses of Benny's discography. That storytelling of him just explaining growing up from being a baby to I'm from an era where they painted your baby shoes bronze, lying to him dropping gems on making it in the drug dealing game. Everything was vivid. The rhyme schemes, 5-syllable rhyme schemes, the different flows, especially when he got that baptized hoes flow like midway through his verse. He had to stand out punching, and then Black Thought got busy, dog. This is honestly one of his better modern verses as well. It's a lot to choose from, but it gotta be up there, dog. The way that he paints these pictures a little bit more abstract, where he'll take allusions to different literature or different people in history, and his technical rapping is better than Benny the Butcher's, which is saying a lot. What he was doing from the sophisticated internal rhymes, the 6-syllable rhyme schemes, I mean, everything there was just on a different level. I would slightly edge Black Thought as having the better verse here, but I ain't mad if you say Benny. Benny probably had the better, like, standout one-line punches, right? The joints that you'll remember after one listening quote. But excellent song. I think that's a 10 out of 10 song easily. This is Sunday School.
Mike motherfucking checking this bitch.
Hey, y'all know how wrestlers got the finishing moves like the F5, the angle slam, like the arpeggiating keys? That's the Derringer special move. Like, if he really want to make a beat jump, he just got to find that key sample, dog. He'll know how to handle the rest when it comes to the drums. And then whoever rapping Conway, Benny, they'll capture that grimy aesthetic. But yeah, this beat is tough. I like those little ominous sounds, too.
Uh-huh. Niggas ain't see what I saw. Brick turn to
a... I love how it's two layers of keys too. This is a great beat, dog.
Gold. Over that, spent my daughter's first birthday locked in the hole. Plot full of gold, came back strong.
Some around scheme. That my daughter's first birthday locked in the hole line is gritty too.
From my block to the stove, not in the cone. Me and West.
This is what I'm saying, dog, with the technical rapping, dog. He's using this 4-syllable rhyme scheme, but he's using it like 5 times within 2 lines. Like, almost every single syllable is rapping, and he's just using one rhyme scheme. That's ridiculous, dog. And to get this while you're getting this level of gritty street imagery, I ain't really experienced nothing before. I mean, you got glimpses of it from other Griselda members, and you definitely get it from like a Rock Marcy, but it just wasn't common before the Rock Marcy era, which led into the Griselda era. It's different, dog.
Niggas dressed like they copying holes. Poppy, come on, stop it. You know you're not with the smoke. I get you. About a year,
still going,
how niggas
dog.
Gonna deny me the throne, huh? Rappers say we so dope and their random actions of violence. Our neighbors in the burbs want to hand us back to the project.
That's
they say
like
I'm on tour while the family package the product. Everybody go
reverse gentrification.
Check with me when y'all want y'all shot. There's 10 shooters in my hood for A1 y'all got. Hey look,
it's
I had to dumb it
right
down
there
for niggas. You gotta do that. It's like bringing down the prices. You gotta move.
See, I never understood when dude said that Benny the Butcher got the same flow. Generally, he only uses laid-back flows, but he has several flow switch-ups. It's just you're not gonna hear no double time or no melodic delivery from Benny. But there's rappers, even rappers who I really appreciate. I've been on this Rome Streets is the best rapper in Griselda run. I think Rome Streets has way less flows than Benny. I think Rome Streets is a slightly better rapper. I've just not heard it on, especially not any of his popular albums. Even on albums like Burden of Proof, it don't be the same song. It might be the same gear, it might be the same types of flows, but I just don't see it.
I was in the feds with braids under the do-rag.
I'm a volunteer to do you if it come to that. I fuck with smart.
Hey, leaders lead, dog.
Brought a quarter thing back. That's a small mission in the dark kitchen. All you hear is the fork clicking in the zone. Looking through the holes of them yard fences.
Dog, I feel like if you heard a Benny the Butcher album, you should be able to put Works in a Trap House on your resume, because this joint is vivid, dog.
Quarter brick, half a brick, whole brick.
Hey!
Fiends still hit me when they dope sick. Put that cook with gas for the raw. So much glass on the floor. I got my bitch kitchen looking like I broke in. Let's go.
So much glass on the floor. Oh, but it's so fire. That's so fire.
My bricks better than theirs. Y'all better come pay dues. An extra gram jumping back for every one they lose. These niggas borrowing the guns they use. Not me, I got my own stick. Like I'm about to come play pool. Riding the car with bricks.
That's so fire. Hey, that line always made me think of the Fresh Prince of Bel-Air when Uncle Phil got the pool hustlers and he pulled out his pool stick. That's a good line. I bought my own stick like I'm finna come play pool. If we play pool and you bring out your own stick, you know, we not in the same caliber of pool players. You D1, I'm just intramural league.
Niggas say they want gunplay cool, but they don't really want gold ass like Sunday school. Them niggas dead on the rival.
I like how you mentioned the name of the song, but yeah, all my folks with street parents felt that line, dog. I love you, but I did not want to go to no church as no kid.
Question the title. No chance for survival. They ain't checking your vitals. A fast call.
It's like a rhyme scheme.
Try and catch up the rivals. I got a lamb and a stick like I'm fresh out the Bible, huh? A young nigga with Mexican.
Dog, I remember I heard that bar. That was instantly, that was bar of the year 2019. One of the best punches. I mean, if that was said in battle rap, dog, the groom would go crazy. Like, that's one of them bars. I remember exactly where I was when I first heard it. I was in my Chevy Malibu going to IKEA. I think I just moved. This high-pitched voice dude come on here, and I want him to hurry up because I'm ready for this Jadakiss verse. But the come play pool bar come on. I sit up in my seat a little bit. The Sunday school line come. I leaned forward a little bit, and then that lamb and the stick line, I literally had my phone in my hand, threw it across the car. I was parked at this point in time. Threw it across the car. If I had a channel and y'all could have saw that reaction, dog, I would have been viral by now. No, that's an amazing line. A lamb and a stick, a Lambo, and then lambs, how shepherds had the lambs and the staff. That's an amazing line, dog. That's crazy. That's not regular.
I just left from Ohio. We met up for Cinco de Mayo. Complexion for connection. I'm melon albino. I went broke and sold wax like I'm selling a vinyl, huh?
Shout out to Dope. Shout out to Copenhagen Crates.
I know you're tight. You're not thorough. You can't come up.
Those last set of rhyme schemes, too. The Fresh Out the Bible rhyme scheme. That was the four syllable rhyme scheme up into that selling wax little scheme there. Those are two of the better rhyme schemes and flows that I've heard from Special.
I've been in charge, but finding the plug just gave me more. Leadership.
I like that.
No scales for the weed and bricks. They wholesale. Only time we see scales when we clean a fish.
Quarter brick, half.
That's so crazy. The way he buying in bulk is so big, he ain't using no, like, digital scales. The only time he sees scales is we cleaning fish scale, which is pure cocaine. That's crazy, dog. Scales on the fish, dog.
It's a shame what we did to the highway. Even worse if we made it there safe when we pulled in the driveway. Yeah. 3.5 whole ones gone by Friday. Gone. Now we riding back smoking. Listen to Sade.
I like that storyteller right there.
Get it off the dock, the plug, come on the jet ski. I gotta be a genius or be deeply educated. Uh-uh. Keep the money and the drugs completely separated.
That's it. Ooh, man, that song is special, dog. I said Crowns for Kings is a 10 out of 10, which it is. Sunday School probably is, too. It's either that or like 9.75 out of 10. It's a dope song, dog. I think Benny really set the bar with another strong verse. The Coke bar specifically was more vivid than they were on Crowns for Kings, where he lightly touched on the coke bars. And when he's in that storytelling bag, it's already special in and of itself. But to add to the fact that I think the rhyme schemes were even better here than they were on the first song. But as good as Benny's verse was, verse of the song go to 38 Special, dog. That verse was disrespectful. I mean, you take just the Fresh Out the Bible line by itself, even if the rest of the verse was filler, the verse would still be amazing just off of that. But then he throwing the Sunday school line in there, the broke selling wax, like, like I'm selling vinyl line. The cleaning fish line is OD. That had to be one of the best verses of 2019. So for you to get three legendary verses, three extremely good verses from Benny's first verse on Crowns for King, Black Dog's verse on Crown for King, and then 38 Specials verse here, for you to get that on a 22-minute album, I think it show you how special this album was. I think Jadakiss had a dope verse too, but I ain't gonna hold you, bro. His joint was like the Broncos winning the championship with Peyton Manning. Like, people be exaggerating how bad Peyton Manning was. Peyton Manning was still like a distributor, and Jadakiss verses was good. But it was Benny and 38 Specials that carried the song along with Derringer. I'm probably exaggerating. The Jadakiss verse wasn't bad. It was really good. It just was the third best verse on here by a decent margin. But I will say he did have the shortest verse on here, which kind of puts him behind the eight ball as far as barring with Benny and Specials. But he played right into it with his vivid storytelling of making that drug play. And then he got into some of those OG jewel dropping bars to close his verse. But then to make the song even more disrespectful, I think the chorus was fire from Benny, and then this beat from Derringer is so fire, dog. Of course the drums sound good, but I like that you have those arpeggiating keys, and then you have this other layer of ascending keys using pretty much one instrument on the harmony, and it still feels textured regardless because you got those two layers of samples. Amazing song. This is Dirty Harry.
My pen moving like I'm improving. I deliver death chains, call me Rick Rubin. Big 9mm or the SIG shooting. Brains hanging out your wig, you a Fig Newton. Speaker knocker, this that 45 woofer. Slaughter guys, and his hit was ordered by the butcher Payne.
It's a good round scheme. I don't love these punchlines like that Fig Newton bar. He ain't getting my favorite one yet, but let's keep going.
And all my hammers got that panoramic view. Is gamble with life to that cannon blame.
Nah, this rhyme scheme is crazy.
Expand a nigga view.
I like that line.
Raw specimen, heat up. Pure medicine. Benny say clean niggas up. I'm George Jefferson. Black
Sopranos. Sorry, you know, dog.
Bars hit you like finding out your daughter a lesbian. We got him hooked.
I'm so That line is so stupid, but I'll be randomly saying it throughout the day. It's one of them lines where it don't make sense that I like it, but I do. It's so basic. And they're like, why is that hitting you hard? I feel like there's a lot harder news than that.
Niggas love when the rain pour. Sorcerer, the torturer, that's what they call me pain for.
I like that sorcerer and turn around skin.
Got that big AR ad. I'm in the dark low.
So fire. That's so fire, dog. Yo, the OBH hammer, OBH, the group with AR Ab and Dark Low. But he said, I got the AR Ab, just saying, I got the AR. I'm in the Dark Low. Dark Low, the rapper, and then I'm in the Dark Low with the AR. That's a crazy line. And then the next dude who he said, Leak Moss, I think he's in OBH too. I don't really listen to him like that. But yeah, that's a dope scheme.
I got the green light from OG, my father, the air. But what I did with a pot will make it hard to compare us. I washed the blood off the money that my daughter's inherited. It kept the barrel so hot that it fogged up the mirrors.
That's crazy, dog. Next time we into some shit. That's crazy.
Rap 5 straight hours, blending up, find great powder. The fumes knock
you out like Dante right here.
Wilder. I call it get rich music, but y'all say albums for niggas who caught the long bids and lost their values.
Uh-huh. He and his Jay-Z 44, I'm trying to give you $1 million worth of game for $9.99 type bag. I like that.
Used to want to get a contract with the Nets, but that changed when I got in contact with a connect.
That's fire, dog.
Still died, nigga, you decide. Last nigga shot at me and missed. It was like committing suicide. I flew to Cali just to find a new drug connect, and I still got a good rapport with all the plugs I met.
That's like in movies when the movie say the name of the movie in the movie. I've said movie way too many times right there.
Big F and bullets flipping nigga charger. Your favorite rappers is my son. I'm the niggas' fathers. I'm the reason all them niggas trying to spit it harder. You rap like you trapped and you
that's
made
a poor seller right there.
We bought that action. We clap and we spray.
Hey, RJ Payne verse was like turning on the heater for the first time. Like, it might take a second for it to heat up, but once it's there, That nigga left Earth like about 6-8 bars into his verse when he got towards that clean niggas up George Jefferson part. I think the rhyme schemes were good from start to finish, but like towards the middle, it was like the delivery got more emphatic, the flows got a little bit faster, and then that OBH line. I mean, that's a really heady line because they're outside of Dark Low, they're really underground. Well, even Dark Low is underground, but he's a little bit more known than the other ones. That's a phenomenal scheme, dog. I think it's a toss up between him and Benny who had the best verse. Benny was a little bit more consistent. RJ had the bigger highs. Instead, a line from Benny to me was that Nets line. And then Conway, I thought that was standard Conway. He had his typical three-syllable rhyme schemes. He heated up a little bit towards the end of his verse, but I think the brags were a little bit standard. He didn't have the standout lines that Benny or that RJ had. I think it was a solid Conway verse, though. I like that beat. You have these twangy sounding synths. The whole beat sounds really abstract because you have those extra ethereal sounds through it. I think that's a really good song. Not quite as good as Crowns for Kings at Sunday School, but dope regardless. This is Took the Money to the Plug's House. What you coming, nigga? The horns under these keys, the real muffle horns, sound dope. I took the money to the I'm from Buffalo where it's cold in summer. All we know is hustling, lower numbers than the Choa brothers. Hey, where it's cold in summer, that might be the grittiest bar in the whole album. I am not about that, like. They know the flow disgusting. I'm not even about cold in winter if we keeping it a buck. 2012, I'm in sales for a sale. Had no patience, all these cats acting gangster, all the crap and affidavits. I like that imagery. They do my last year numbers at best. I ain't fumbled that yet. It's funny cause I'm getting running back checks. That ain't age where running backs don't get paid nothing. I'm way the same for coming at West. Swinging an axe, doing lumberjack reps. I'm lucky, so an extra is a spade. Man, he had about 4 flows on this verse. It's a good verse if you add on the fact that there's so much imagery tied into each line. He made his first 10 bands, let's applaud the brother. If you do that 10 times, now you want something. This shit, I like don't say no more. I need duct tape and gloves, pots, 2 plates, and scrubs. A spot where the neighbors good, a place where the fiends do favors for the neighborhood. Come and cop and leave with extra rocks. He hooked the cable up. Miss me with that famous thing. Man, that's so far. He been going with the same rhyme scheme for pretty much the whole verse too. I think those first 4 bars had a different rhyme scheme, but that's tough.
That's where I got my flavor from. Had me putting paper together just like a staple gun. It won't make you equal unless you put pretty on all line. Your people. Got one first, now my whole team got bezels you can see through.
That's a pretty good song. I like the beat from Alchemist. Even though the keys were the most prominent part of that beat, I think my favorite part about the beat was those real bassy, low register horns that were present under the keys. Drum sounded good too. I think the rapping was pretty dope from Benny. Just like with Dirty Harry, it's not quite on par with the verses from Crowns for Kings at Sunday School, but those are just gonna be hard verses to live up to. Imagery was dope. He switched up the flows a lot on that first verse, and then on that second verse, I really like how he took that one rhyme scheme for like 75% of his verse. He has some nice little jabs in there too. It's a dope song. Not the best song here, but it's pretty good. This is 18 Wheeler.
Let's go.
These reverb down sounds.
The Butcher Old Connect was tighter than them Doce runners. First time I ever cooked the deuce, I got a 4-way from it. Stabbed it in a pot so many times, they think OJ done it.
That OJ line is fire.
Push with a link back when I was a dealer. That's an 18 Willow to my town from Virginia. Enough glitter on my neck to make my ex bitch bitter.
I like the name of the song. I could be wrong, but I think the 18 Wheeler is a reference to Push's line on Drug Dealers Anonymous that my name and 18 Wheelers is evidence. I'm almost positive that's the meaning of this name. It could have been for something older that I'm forgetting, but I'm pretty sure.
I took my chances when I was scrambling without no license. Yes, I really took those type of risks. I'm laughing at indictment threats.
I mean, you got drugs in the car, no light. Well, you might not get stopped. You probably should have a license if you weren't into drugs.
When I was locked, never called, but I used to send mail home. I got close homies who caught in new cases on jail phones. Velcro strapped and clip got a
I like that line. Stay off them phones, dog.
Counting up when a bitch got the 50, a nail broke. They talking racks, but and I flooded my corner right after the scale broke.
He talking slick, dog.
I'm not a nigga, she tell no.
Yeah, cause new gangsters pointing guns at the camera. Never. I bet you niggas practicing the mirror.
It depend on where they from. Some of these dudes out here practicing on the ops.
Brick of money to your earlobe. 6 picks same brick, something weird though. They say a hero's nothing but a sandwich. The 488 coming through like the praying mantis. My bitches got standards. The only drug dealer out at Fashion Week with an 80-20 split like Master P.
I ain't gonna say that. Only Jay-Z don't be at Fashion Week. But anyway, he flexing, dog. He is really polished when it comes to mixing that drug lingo with the luxury lingo. Other rappers has done it to an extent, but given that he is a coke rapper where I think other rappers just sold coke, he gotta be at the top of, towards the top of the list. And then I like that 80-20 split, the 80-20 split on the drug negotiation, and then Master P's taking 80-20 off his deals, record deals.
Why would I ever 50-50? You ain't half for me. Benny the Butcher coming after me.
You know, I hate to be that guy, but since drug dealers know how to flip kilos to ounces to pounds, if they were half of you, you should be getting 66 and they should be getting 33. I gotta lay down the map because Beanie finna give us some calculus on his next song. Spoiler alert. Benny helped himself a lot because the fact that the music on this album is just amazing. But I think the cosigns from Black Thought and Pusha T were really huge for him. Black Thought does work with a lot of dope underground rappers. His is more so the fact that he was able to have a Black Thought verse and be right there with Black Thought, which a lot of rappers can't say. But then the Pusha T, like, we talk about Passion of Torch moments. This is it, dog. This is when it went from Magic and Larry Bird's league to Jordan's league as far as coke rap goes. But even sonically, man, this song is pretty dope. This is not my favorite beat. I like the other DJ Shay produced song, Crowns for Kings, the production on that song more, but I think it fit the aesthetic of the song really well. It just didn't have any standout instruments or standout elements of the beat like a lot of the other songs did. I think the rapping was sick from both. Benny had the better verse. I think Pete for Pete at that point in their careers, Benny the Butcher was just a better rapper than Pusha T. But I do like the fact that Pusha T played to his strengths, and instead of trying to go super lyrical 4 or 5 syllable rhyme schemes, he did what he does best in this run of his career and mixed that luxury talk and talking about all the wealth that him selling drugs has brought him, getting into that bag. And then Benny did his thing with some of the most vivid coke bars on the album. I think the song is really, really sick from a rap perspective. I think it's good from a production standpoint. And I think the last two songs, if you just gotta say which of the lightest two songs on the album, it gotta be those two. But I would still say that up to this point in time, this album is 5 for 5. Let's close this thing out with 5 to 50. I think what Alchemist is doing right now, this leads to some of the grimiest beats where you just take this one synth or violin note, whatever it is, and they just hold that note. Like, for example, Derringer did it on the song Rex Ryan. Of course, there's other elements to this beat, but that's what's driving the melody. That's sick. And then on top of that, he's adding this little wobble effect to it that's making it even more disorienting and grimy. This beat is crazy.
I've been selling dreams to sleepers, nigga. Tell the truth, that's the perfect business. Cause in a drought, I was paying double for some work that wasn't even worth the ticket. Place scrapers with the work to get it. Check my bank statements, probably hurt your feelings.
How
I'm in every verse admitting how I work a kitchen like it's church's chicken. First around, ain't no work around. You gotta hit it twice just to make it last. Take a quarter, make a quarter. Put that together, that'll make a half. With a coke compressor, it's... Matter of fact, ain't telling niggas shit. Who are these niggas?
The same way how I felt that the Crowns for Kings opening bars are like the perfect way to open, this is the perfect way. Like, for this album to be all about drug dealing, this, in my opinion, was the most vivid when it just comes to straight, like, I'm in the trap cooking up, turning this 5 to 50. I like to take a quarter, you make a quarter, put that together, and then he's like, nah, man, if I ain't telling y'all nothing. Like, you could just hear the passion elevating in his voice. It's like, never mind, I ain't saying nothing. That's tough.
I'm independent, but they think that I'm sounding shady because my jewelry look like I made it.
Just I like got that house.
I need a brand new Mercedes. We kicking ass like the baby. I'm on the grind. I link with the plugs that I met one more time if these labels don't pay me.
Hey, when he said it, I feel like he mean it too. And then once again, the movie said the name of the movie. He said plugs I met. That's always gonna hit. Hey, and that kicking butt like the baby line though, you know, I give credit to that line, but I'm not giving credit to the baby because every video I seen, he was jumping somebody. It's very easy to fight somebody when your security is helping you.
It was like Benny from Montana. It was like, be careful with that. It was like
I like how you threw that bass in the beats and that chorus right there. Or pseudo chorus.
Picked up my mama's house, came back carrying things in. Be careful, cause they give you five for a robbery, but they bury in kingpin.
That's a fact. I like that.
These investigations current, nigga. The wiretaps got me playing it safe. Ask Earl Howard about it if you think I'm frontin' about that 20 grand a day. This the only block on the east side where the dope shooters all come and get it. Quarterback and plays from a kitchen, how I honor student, gonna come a chemist.
Bro, you hear the passion in his voice with the imagery? Because he gets vivid a lot with this song. It's just a different level when it comes to delivery. And then the this the only block on the east side where the dope shooters all come and get it. It remind me of, man, both Conway and Westside Gunn, I believe, are both felons. Like, these dudes was out here selling drugs. But if you listen to, I think it was a Westside Gunn interview on the Joe Budden podcast, like, the way that they talk about Benny and how Benny grew up, like, Westside Gunn and Conway acknowledge that they grew up and where they had to turn to, but Westside Gunn was like, yeah, what Benny had to go through, like, that nigga was in the slums, like, his block. And you feel this on the passion on this song.
In the road to riches or jail bars with some niggas that I burn in hell for.
I went burning hell for nobody.
Daydreaming by my past, on while I'm driving, hoping I don't crash. Loyal country freedom that I
this
only last
fire.
Long as I'm balling bulls versus the jazz. And before you niggas ever got some cash, I can put 200 grams on every half. That's another 20 if you do the math. Carry zeros over every time I ask. West Side Bill, nigga, I was glad. Got me out the hood.
Hey, that man was mapping too. He said, I can put 200 grams on every half. I done broke this down before. A pound is like 446 grams, 440 and some change grams. So a half is, we'll round it, call it 220. But he's saying he can get away with only putting 200 grams and a half. So that's another 20. But then that leads to the punch, I think, which makes it dope, to carry zeros over every time I add. Like in math, when you add up, when you have to carry the one, you have to carry the number, then zeros is like a double entendre for carry ounces over every time I add. Come on, dog. Well, technically you don't carry zeros over, but you know, we get the point. That's a fire bar.
Still owe my plug for another half. Every time you bring my name up, he get mad. Then I turn
I like
my flip
that.
Phone to a stash. Six figures legal money. That ain't bad. Three
it's
times
not.
And now I run a business. Every plug I ever met, I made them cash. Before I wrote a drug stories and I laugh. Talking about the coke sales they never had. Pull up on a nigga, you gon' know the pad. Only house with a Bentley on the grass.
Hey, speaking of having a Bentley on the grass, that's like how I feel about Benny's early albums that didn't have Derringer and Alchemist. When he was rapping over them little demo beats on, like, my first brick, it felt like a Bentley on the grass.
Benny doing what he loved to do. Worry about no more police kicking in our doors.
Dog, that is a perfect ender to an album, dog. The only reason this isn't far and away the best song on the album is because you got another ridiculous song in Crowns for Kings. It has to be top five-ish, I would say, and that's saying a lot because Tana Talk has a lot of really dope songs, but the beat is just so ominous and grimy. I like the stories from India to take the place of a chorus. This was the most blatant flow switch up that I heard from Benny up to this point, where he kind of almost got that double time back. I remember the comments when this album first came out was how big of a flow switch up this was for him, and I would agree with that. But for me, even more impressive than the flows was the delivery, like the passion just oozing off every single line. The level of details throughout this album when he got in those drug tales, it just picked up from 18 Wheeler probably being the second most vivid. Now the whole album is vivid, but just specifically talking about trapping, and then this just surpassed that. Three really strong verses. You can kind of take your pick over which one is best. Gun to my head, I would probably take the third verse because I think it's just a perfect conclusion to both the song and the album. But man, amazing song and an amazing album. Now, if I'm ranking all of Benny's projects, my gut tells me Tana Talk 3. I've had that comfortably over Plugs. It was just a longer, more ambitious album. And then I got Plugs number 2 slightly above Tana Talk 4. I mean, this album is special. You got one of the best songs of the last decade in Crowns for Kings. That's a modern hip-hop classic, in my opinion. 5 to 50 is one of Benny's best songs. Sunday School had one of the craziest verses. Now, the only downside of the album is I think the highs from the first two songs and then 5 to 50 were so high that it makes really good songs like Dirty Harry and Took the Money to the Plug House sound regular just within context of the album. Like, if you were to take those those two songs plus 18 Wheeler and turn into a three pack. It'll be a really fire three pack, but it's a different caliber between those other three songs. But add to the good vivid rap and you have fire production. I thought all the producers were special. I think 18 Wheeler is probably my least favorite beat. I know that's gonna upset some of y'all, but hey, it is what it is. But Shay also had one of the best beats in Crowns for Kings. Alchemist did his thing, B Butcher did his thing, and then the features on here, they look good on paper and they all came with it. It's a really good feature list when Conway the Machine got the worst verse on a verse that was still pretty solid. But Black Thought, he had the best feature on this album. Pain came with it, Pusha T came with it. For an album barely over 20 minutes, this thing covered a lot of ground and it's special.